stay still. And then you calm down. When you take a deep breath, make your mind relax and your body also relax. Take a deep breath. You feel relaxed. You are inside. And sometimes, you know, when you get to the problem or you feel uncomfortable in your mind, and then it will be automatically by the nature, like the people that you know. That's the nature is to release. You need to release. So, Buddha himself, he came out this technique and then he practiced in the Bodhi tree, and then he get the peace of mind. And but you have to develop mindfulness. This is the key. You know the technique, but if you don't practice until you get the mindfulness automatically, like it works for you automatically, and then you can use it immediately when you have something happen. Mindfulness is like a safeguard. Where is the suffering and where is happiness occur? Do you know that? Do you know that? Where is the happiness happen? Where is the suffering happen? Where? You know what? The brain. Oh, it says the brain. Anything else? Anybody?
Personal life.
Huh?
Your personal life.
Okay. Thank you. In Buddhism, we consider the suffering. Suffering as the bad gates to visit your house. Your house is mine. Okay? And suffering is like a bad case to come to you. Greed and death and delusion, this one bad person to come to your house. And good person like compassionate or loving kindness or any kind of the virtue that good in your mind if you have that kind of thing. And your house, you have to have door, right? And you open the door to receive your guests. Good and bad. Some people good, some people bad. In your daily life also, you have to open the door to receive them. So, I want to say that we have to have the safeguard or the